Hi everyone, today we will study about the two types of verbs, finite verb and non-finite verb. So here, let's start with the first kind, finite verb. Finite means fixed. So finite verb means fixed verb. Finite verb change their forms when there is a change in the number or person of the subject. Finite verbs change their forms when there is a change in the number or person of the subject. Second point, verbs which have the past or the present form. These kind of verbs are called finite verbs. Means, in another word, we can say that these type of verbs, means finite verbs, have to agree with the number or person of the sentence and with the tense of the sentence. For example, here we have some examples. So first one we have, we go. We go. This is simple present tense. And here, she goes. This is also simple present tense. Now, this is a verb and this is also a verb. So here we have plural subject. According to the rule of the simple present tense, with the plural subject, we use the base form of the verb. And with the singular subject, we use V1 plus S or ES. So here we have seen that the verb changes its form according to the number of the person. Means here we have plural subject, go, and the singular subject, goes. Now come on the third one. I went, went. This is the second form of verb, go. Go, went. First form, go, and the second form is went. So here we have seen that according to the tense, verb changes its form. Okay? Getting? So, if the tense of the sentence changes, the forms of the verb also changes. In the simple present tense, we use V1 and in the simple past tense, we use V2. Now let's move on. Second type of verbs, non-finite verbs. Non-finite means not fixed. Non-finite verbs do not change their form when the number or person of the subject changes. Second point, forms of verb which do not work as a complete verb and neither depend on the number and person of subject. Means, these verbs are not bound by the number, person, tense and subject of a sentence. These verbs are not bound by the number, person, tense and subject of the sentence. For example, we try to sing. So we try, subject plus verb, and this is also verb. Here we have two verbs in one sentence. Okay, so here subject plus V1. V1 means this is simple present tense. So this is our finite verb. And the second verb, to sing. This is the non-finite verb. And here we have another sentence. I liked to write. Liked. This is V2. Second form of the verb. Mean this is simple past tense. And here in the simple past tense, I liked to write. And this is V1, this is V2. So here, to write, this is non-finite verb. It doesn't change its form according to the tense. So in short, we can say verbs with tenses are the finite verbs and verbs without tenses are called non-finite verbs. Now here we have some more examples. Rohan went to market, bought a pen. Rohan went to market, bought a pen. Here we have one verb, and here also we have one verb. So it doesn't look nice. That's V2 is here and again V2 is here. So there is no any tense. If we will use full stop here, Rohan went to the market, then it become a sentence. But if there is no any full stop here, we will say Rohan went to market, bought a pen. So we have to add here and. We have to use one conjunction word here. Rohan went to market and bought a pen. Because in one sentence, we cannot use two finite verbs. In one sentence, we can use so many non-finite verbs. But in one sentence, we can't use two finite verbs. If we are using two finite verbs, then that sentence become two sentences. And we have to join by the conjunction word. Conjunction. Conjunction is a word that combines two sentences. But practically, we are saying that the conjunction is a word that combines two finite verbs. Because when we have two finite verbs, we have to use a conjunction word. So before using and here, it was a wrong sentence. Rohan went to market, bought a pen. This is not a right sentence. Rohan went to market and bought a pen. So in one sentence, we can use only one finite verb. And along with this, in one sentence, we can use only one finite verb. But we can use so many, means 20, 40, 50 non-finite verbs. So in this sentence, I want to go to him, to talk to him, to convince him to restart his preparation after failing in the exam. So here we have one verb is here, to go, to talk, to convince, to restart and failing. So this is the finite verb. We have one finite verb in this sentence. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We have used here 5 non-finite verbs. So in one sentence, we can use only one finite verb and so many non-finite verbs. So I hope you understood the concept of finite verb and non-finite verbs. Finite verbs means limited by number, person, and tense of the sentence. And the non-finite verbs, not limited by number, person, and tense of the sentence. Means the verbs with the tenses are finite verb and the verbs without the tenses are non-finite verbs. So now it's time to the homework. Circle the finite verbs and underline the non-finite verbs. I'm giving you the 10 sentences. You have to write down in your notebook and you will write down. You will have to underline and circle. Circle the finite verbs and underline the non-finite verb. Because when you do more practice, you will understand better. Have a nice day.